gambled away this house.
What?
Our house!
Mom, are you sure about this? I mean, who gambles with their houses?
Selfish men like your father.
Wait, wait. Are you trying to say Dad used our house as a gambling bet?
No. He borrowed 15 million naira from a company using this house as collateral.
Okay, so how did gambling come into this?
Bianca, my dear, as he said, the money from the failed investment was gambled away. His reason being that he wants to raise enough money to pay the company back. Have you heard a more stupid reason for somebody to be gambling?
God. Where do we go from here?
Where?
Just tell me.
We are just done for doom.
My dear, I'm truly sorry. I didn't mean to fail both of you.
Dad, why did you break the promise you made to us?
It seems the only way out. I made only 5 million naira from the investment.
And you gambled it away just like that?
You see, that 5 million naira would have yielded more than 30 million naira if it had clicked.
Well, it didn't click. None of your gambling has ever clicked, yet you keep playing it. Now you've gambled away the only property you have remaining. What do we do when the company comes to take this house away? What? Which company?
Starlight Company.
What? Dad! Do you know I am preparing for a test to get employment in this same company? Tomorrow morning, Dad, yes. Oh my God. Dad, why do you keep doing everything to ruin my life?
To see you like this. I mean, whatever this is, it's gonna be all right.
Would you mind talking to me, or better still, you tell me, how did your interview go?
Well, I wrote well, but I'm not happy.
I mean, but it's not that bad.
What could be worse than losing your home? I mean, growing up in your own father's house, and all of a sudden you turn out to become a tenant in another man's house, all because your father gambled away your home.
Hmm. So in that case, do you mind moving in with me? Please.
What about my parents?
They can get an affordable accommodation somewhere.
With which money? You know I don't have a job yet. Or do you want to sort that out?
I would have loved to help, but babe, you know how much it cost me to get this new place and to furnish it. And come to think of that, our wedding was shifted because of financial reasons. Please do not get me wrong, baby.
I know. I understand. Just that it breaks my heart that in less than 2 weeks, we'll be homeless. That house holds a lot of childhood memories.
See your wife and you're chasing me out without a drink.
We're done with this discussion, okay?
Why so it is name on the stop beating your wife.
Stop beating your wife.
It could begin.
Sometimes I feel that your father is cursed. Or is it me?
None of you are. Dad just can't get over a bad habit.
7 days. Bianca, in 7 days, this house will be gone. A house that is worth over 60 million naira will be gone because of 50 million naira loan.
It's okay. Put yourself together.
Remember your blood pressure. Let's go to bed. Go to see what's true.
How can I go back to Ghana empty-handed? After spending over 25 years in Nigeria, I will go back to Ghana a pauper?
Nothing of such will happen. Something must come up here. It's okay. Stop crying. Stop.
When is your interview tomorrow?
9 a.m.
Same company. I just pray they don't connect you with your father.
I pray so much. I do.
Just.
So what's my schedule for the day?
Sir, the applicants are here.
but the management considers one of them.
And who is that?
Her name is Bianca Manu.
Okay, send her in.
Hello, Dad. Okay, I'll see you by the weekend. All right, sir. So what are you doing in Nigeria?
I was born here. I've lived here all my life.
Oh, I see.
That's nice. I can see you made a first class in business administration.
Yes, sir. I was very serious in my studies.
Quite impressive. Quite impressive. And your grades and experience, well, good. Good. I think you have what we want. And I might be wrong, but correct me if I am. Your surname sounds exactly like that of the man I went through his file last night over loan default case. Are you in any way related to Mr. Kofi Man from Accra? I just asked you a question, young lady.
Yes, sir, he's my father.
Is this a joke or something? You came here to look for work when your father is owing us 15 million naira.
No, sir. I didn't know about it. I already applied for the job before I found out.
And you still came? How are you intending to pay back? Probably from the salary we pay you here, isn't it? And how long do you think you would work to earn that kind of money?
If you will permit me, I will gladly do that.
I'm sorry, I will not permit you. I would only ask you to kindly and please leave my office now.
Okay, even if you don't want to give me the job, please give us some time.
If you throw us out, we'll be homeless. Please, sir. Thank you.
Please leave my office. You can go back to Ghana. Ben! Take this girl.
Sir, please, I'm begging you. Sir, please, I'm begging you.
Madam, please, let me show you to the door.
Sir, please, can
you leave this office, please? Sir, please, thank you. Ben, will you take this girl out of here? Get out of my office, please! Next person, please.
It could begin.
So you leave this place now?
Sometimes, unpleasantly, in this journey of life.
Oh, God.
Oh, this journey of life, yeah. And you have no idea.
Hi, baby. Oh, I'm sorry for keeping you waiting. I had too many things to do at the theater. So tell me, how did it go?
This journey of life.
You're crying.
Oh, you can fight it and resist it.
They found out? Oh my goodness. I really wish this didn't happen. It's okay, baby. It's okay. It's okay.
Just look at how my father's callousness is destroying my life.
Listen. Father's callousness is not destroying your life. I mean, there are too many big companies out there. Just cheer up. I mean, look, you'll keep going for the test, and believe in me that someday you will excel.
You don't understand. This is a company that I have dreamt so much of working with. They pay so well, you know it.
Honey, I understand. Look, first of all, I need you to stop crying, okay? Just stop this, please. Listen, I understand this, but I want you to look at it from the angle where it could be a blessing in disguise. And I also heard the guy handling that company is some kind of nasty person.
That's an understatement. The guy is a beast.
Wait, hold on. So you've heard too?
I met him today.
How come?
It happened to be that he was the one that conducted the interview. That was how he found out that my surname and address was same with my dad's.
That was too smart of him. Shit! That means the tablet was right. I heard the guy is some kind of guru, and that's why he's been able to manage his father's empire so well.
You mean the guy is a snob?
Can you please take it easy on yourself, please? Hmm? Boo boo. Poochie poochie. Baby. Come on. Oh, it's alright, darling. Oh, I know you're very hungry and I think I need to order something for you. But where is this guy? You need to eat something, darling.
Don't worry.
No, you don't want anything?
Okay.
Are you sure about this?
I just want to go home. That's all I want now.
I know you missed me just like you miss your frequent meetings.
Wow. I think it's time.
You start considering that advice seriously.
Becky, that's no advice. That's a trap. You don't hinge a man's inheritance on marriage. Where have you heard that done before?
If you had done the right thing, Dad wouldn't have had the grounds to do so.
You amazed me, Becky. You think that is right in what he did? Thanks for taking sides with me.
Come on. It's not about taking sides, darling. Listen. I don't need Dad to tell me before I start thinking of what is good for you. I know what is good for you.
How will marriage do me any good? What's the big deal? Why should that qualify me from getting my inheritance?
You are no longer a kid. I came out a year and some months before you did. And as you can see, I'm truly childbearing.
The fact that we are almost age mates does not mean our lives will go the same way. I'm doing good at handling and managing that empire. Why doesn't it leave it at that?
It's time you forget Victoria's death.
No, no, no. Leave her out of this, please.
Let someone help you here.
I said leave her out of this!
It's okay, it's okay. Calm down. Clara, I care so much about you. The papers for me and my family to relocate, we'll soon be out. And I don't want you lonely when I'm gone.
When I find a woman that's worth it, I'll do it.
You did it 1,000 times, but you never wanted any of them.
Whatever. What do they have there, sorry?
Oh, I never knew you were hungry.
If I don't get something to chew and drink now, I'll cut off your head.
Oh, excuse me, please don't cut off my head. Waiter!
Waiter!
Hey, bro. What are you doing in my house, Maxwell?
Anyways, I was just around the neighborhood and decided to come and find out how your wife, Sachin, is going.
Maxwell, If you stayed out of my business, you might live a little longer.
Come on, man. Don't be too uptight. I said I was just around the neighborhood and decided to check on you to know how your wife searching is going. Did I do any wrong?
Please leave my house.
As in, I should.
Find your way out of this compound, please. I don't want to get violent with you.
Okay. Good luck.
Why is it that every time I mention marriage, your countenance changes?
That my countenance cannot change over an overflogged topic. I'm used to that.
It is overflogged because you are overdue for marriage. Anyway, I called you back again to remind you that you must get married. And not only that, to add a deadline to it.
How do you mean?
A financial expert like you should know what deadline means.
Why would you give me a deadline to get married? Who does that? Dad, why are you taking this out of context? Why are you pushing this far? Dad, you really have to take this easy because you're beginning to push it too far, okay? I don't need any more pressures. I have a lot of that on me already from the office. And yourself, you know your health is not getting any better. You need to calm down. In fact, I suggest you go abroad so you take proper care of yourself. And not all this unnecessary bickering and getting worked up over nothing.
I already know that. And I'm taking precautionary measures. I don't even need to go abroad for treatment. We have hospitals here that can take care of my case. Oh, yes. And listen, my own is that you must get married. And let me let you know this. The doctor has already given me a deadline. He says I have only 6 months to live.
What are you talking about?
You heard me.
That... Six months? Hi. How? Why? Oh my God.
Bianca, you would do no such thing. I mean, how could Jerry even suggest that? What will my fellow Christian women say if they hear you moved into a man's house before wedding?
It's okay, Mom. I didn't accept.
So why bother telling me?
Nothing, I just felt like telling you.
Abba, I would like to have more with you.
Really?
Yeah.
Have you gotten the company's money?
Abba, please don't start. Not now, please.
Mom.
Well, my brother says we can move over to his boys' quarter. The boys' quarter of his 5-bedroom duplex.
Excuse me? So, we are meant to jump up and clap for you for saving the day. From a mansion to a boys' quarter. Ah! Man, no. In all honesty, you are the biggest mistake. You are the biggest disappointment of my life. Now you listen. You better come up with a good plan for us to stay in this house.
Boys quarter, man.
So, Dad, what happens to our property?
Some of them will be parked at the garage. Why I moved the remaining ones to another of my friend's garage
Are you trying to say there's no hope of salvaging this situation?
My dear, there's no hope for now. No hope. I'm so sorry. Truly sorry, my dear. I hope you don't hate me for this.
I'll be in my room, Dad.
It could begin so unexpectedly. Sometime.
Dad?
Calm down.
What happened to him?
Calm down. That's fine. Just like he's giving me 6 months to get married.
You don't see.
That's how long he's got to live.
Good morning, Mr. Isaac.
You may sit.
Thank you.
Bend over to this. Good morning, madam. I'd appreciate if you go straight to the point with whatever you have come here to say. I do not really entertain people I haven't given appointments.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for your time. I really do appreciate how busy you are and...
Can you go straight to the point, please?
Okay. Sorry about that. I came because of my husband's loan.
What about it?
Please, Mr. Eze, can you give us more time?
What more time are you talking about? How much more time do you think you need to pay off 15 million naira? Look, woman, I am aware that that house is the only property he hasn't gambled away, as is known by everybody. So if you think you can come here and whip up sentiments, then you're in the wrong place. If that's the reason you're here, kindly get up and leave my office.
Okay. One more last thing.
Now. What?
Please. Employ my daughter, Mr. Eze, please. I'm sure you can do that for us at least.
I knew that's the singular reason you're here.
No.
Your daughter thinks she's smart, right? She calls you to come here and whip up sympathy and have me employ her. Now you go tell her I said no. Capital no.
I'm sorry to tell you this. She doesn't know I came to see
Madam,
you.
Madam, if you do not mind, leave my office.
Please, Mr. Eze. We will be homeless.
I don't care! Ben, take this man out of my office!
Please.
Madam, please, you may have to leave now.
We'll be homeless and...
I don't care. What's that?
What is it, madam?
Hey, sir, what?
Sir.
No, no, not
sir,
here.
What is it?
You're not going to be in my office. Hello?
Madam.
Hello, madam. With your gambling habits. Let go of me! Fool! Me?
Mr. Baron, don't you ever insult my father again.
I will insult your whole generation and nothing will happen.
Don't you
please, calm down.
People should hold it.
Where's my mom?
Oh, well, at the moment her blood pressure is outrageously so high. And I think she has to be placed under bed rest for some days. Please, but I assure you one thing, that she'll be fine. I need to get back to the ward to fix other things. Excuse me.
This man is a killer!
You are an imbecile.
Your mom fainted in his office. What kind of evil are you? You are evil! You are evil!
You are demented.
What kind of devil are you? What kind of devil are you?
Could begin so unexpectedly. Sometimes
he shouldn't have gone to his office. Now he has provoked you to this level and your blood pressure has gone up, Mom.
It's not him. It's your father.
I know that man. He can be very hostile.
It's expected. But at least he brought me to the hospital.
Hello, everyone. Hi, ma.
Okay.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
At this point, I think you need to just relax yourself. You don't need to stress yourself at all.
I'll be homeless soon. And you're telling me to rest. How can I do that? You know it's not possible.
All of the world.
Mr. Eze.
Yeah, good evening, madam.
Sorry, please, excuse me.
Good evening.
Thank you for bringing me to the hospital.
Yeah, I had to do what I needed to do to make sure you're okay.
You've done more than enough.
I have settled your bills.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. I just came to check up on you. Now that I can see you're in a stable condition, I have to rush back to work.
All right.
Sorry, one more thing, please. I beg you in God's name. Do not ever come to my office to put up this kind of display next time. I might not be this nice. Have a nice day.
Mom, please, can you stop? Consider your health.
I really felt some miracle would have happened by now. That was why I went to Mr. Eze's office.
I am glad you can now say that such a movement is a very big mistake.
Your stupidness that got us into this mess is a big mistake.
Please.
How can he say that my attempt to plead with Mr. Eze is a mistake? Sorry, eh? Dad. If he had granted my request, would he call it a mistake?
It's okay. It's okay. Dad, please stop provoking Mom.
How am I provoking her? She went there without my knowledge. It should have been both of us on the same mission.
Really?
Yeah.
When you are drowning yourself in alcohol, eh? How could you have coordinated any meaningful speech before Mr. Eze? Gambler.
Meaning, is he God?
You ought to be ashamed of yourself for asking that question. I wonder what made me marry you. Eh? A man that has the power to render you homeless is already playing God in your life.
Mom, Dad,
can both of you stop already? You're driving me insane.
Good day, Mr. and Mrs. Kofi.
Good morning, Mr. Eze. Thank you for paying my bills.
Oh, no, it's nothing. You collapsed in my office and people were beginning to make insinuations that I caused it. So I had to do what I had to do.
It's not your fault. I have the condition for a while.
Oh, really?
Yes.
No. Please, I have to go now. I want to go and move some of our things to Uncle's house.
Already.
I'm not so fast.
Eh? Are you also going to take my furniture and other belongings in the house, Mr. Company Owner?
Well, Mr. Kofi, I have a proposition to make to your family.
Which is?
I'll pay your debts. But that's attached to a condition. Just one tiny little condition.
Which is?
Bianca marries me.
I can't marry you. I have someone else to marry.
Really? So why didn't he offset your dad's debt?
He's just a medical doctor.
Oh, I see. Cool. Okay then. Well, I thought you were going to be smart enough to grab this opportunity. The truth is, I don't need you to secure my inheritance. But you need me to remedy this situation. You have made your choice. Do quick to get your things packed. My boys will be there tomorrow morning.
Dad, no.
He said he wants me to marry him on contract basis to enable him to secure his inheritance from his dad. It's okay. Mom!
Yes? You heard him say it's contract. Probably it won't last long and we'll get our house back.
So this rumor that he always fails out with his father due to marriage is true?
Manu, snap out of it. There's no time for rumors. All I'm saying is that Bianca should accept the offer and save the situation on ground. Please.
I think I'm of the same opinion.
I can't believe this. I can't believe you two are trying to sell me off to a total stranger just because of a selfish desire.
My daughter, don't call it selfish desire. It's about family purity.
Bianca, please. It's obvious Jerry can't afford to pay the loan. If Jerry were in your shoes, believe me, he would accept this. Men are selfish.
Please. We need the house. Remember, we are your only parents. But he's not the only man.
Jerry is not the only man. If he loves you, he will wait for you.
Yes, my daughter. Most men are selfish, but not all men.
Maxwell, I sent for you because of the incessant reports of you assaulting your wife ever since you got married. This is not good. That is not how to treat a woman. It's not in the blood. It's not in the family. I don't know where you got this from.
But Dad.
Maxwell, you must treat your woman properly. Honestly, you must stop beating your wife. There are other ways to solve the problem. I will not talk to you about this again. You will not like what will come out of it. I'll see you over the weekend.
Dad. Dad, it's you.
could begin so unexpectedly. Sometimes unpleasantly in this journey of life.
Oh. What's up, man? You sounded worried on phone.
Oh boy, everything seems to be going wrong.
Tell me.
I need to manipulate some accounts. You know, I've been taking some money from there.
Why do you need to do that? You're still in charge of that company.
My old man suddenly developed interests in the account, and he needs a statement this weekend.
Do you think he suspects something is fishy?
Probably.
And the worst part is that
he also noticed I still beat Miriam.
But I have warned you to stop beating your wife. Why do you still beat your wife?
TJ, please, don't blame me. You're not here to blame me.
So, how did he know? Did she report him?
He dares not. Well, he invited us over for dinner the other day. That was how he found out.
But how could you still take your wife to your father after punching her?
TJ, at times, sir, you ask questions like a dumb person. I tell you. See, seeing me with my pregnant wife endears me more to him. And it gives me an edge over Baron.
Honey, I'm back.
Welcome.
CJ, you are here.
Welcome. She's pregnant.
Yes.
And she's coming from Atlanta.
Yes.
Wow. Congratulations, my man. Man, you're winning. You're winning. You're winning, man. Congrats. Thank you. Congrats.
And who the hell does he think he is? So because he's sitting on some kind of empire that gives him the nerve to have any kind of woman he wants, and to think your parents are condescending into what he said drives me crazy.
Honey, calm down. My parents are only in desperate situation, that's all.
That's not true. I mean, that goes a long way to show me how much they like me. And I'm sorry to say this, I am totally disappointed in the choice you're making. Bianca, listen up. You are not doing this. And that is fine now. Don't tell me you are considering doing this.
Not really. But I was thinking, since it's just on contract basis.
Please, just forget it. Okay? Forget it. You are not doing it. Now for Christ's sake, how do you think I feel here you talking about this?
Jerry, for once, can you stop thinking about yourself and consider my aged parents? My parents will be homeless!
Oh, please. To be very honest with you, your father deserves to be homeless because he messed up big time.
How dare you? How dare you talk about my father like that? Yes, he has made some mistakes in the past, but he still remains my father. I should be accorded some respect in my presence.
Respect my foot.
Okay. So, will you offset the bills for them?
Why don't you think of a better way to insult me, Bianca?
Same here.
I don't like what is happening right now, please. I don't like it. Okay, fine. Think about this. Why not if your father swallow his pride and go and live with his brother? I mean, after our wedding, we could think of a better way to help them out.
Jerry, I want to ask you something. And I want you to be very honest with me. If you happen to find yourself in my shoes right now,
Okay.
And some girl offers you a contract marriage to save your parents from their mess. What will you do?
Hi, bro.
What's up, Peggy? Why haven't you been picking my calls?
Sorry, bro. I was driving. I was on my phone.
What's up?
Have you found a wife?
Yes.
Really? So fast? Anyone I know?
No. I only just met her myself.
Baron, I don't think it's right to marry a stranger. Your old friends should be safer. At least someone that will understand you.
Well, this is just contract marriage.
What? Contract? Oh, Baron. Ah, that's more dangerous.
She might turn around against you all.
She might refuse to go when the time comes.
Nah, that's not likely. She's engaged to someone else already. She doesn't even want to do this.
Huh. And you're sounding as if she has agreed already.
Well, I'm hoping that she'll agree before 12 noon tomorrow.
Baron, you always feel the word must be at your beck and call.
Let's finish this.
Later. Let me call you when I get home.
Okay then. My regards to Richard and Kennedy.
Alright. Okay. Bye. Take care of you.
Bye.
You may sit.
It could begin so unexpectedly.
I believe your coming here means you have accepted to do it.
Not yet. I need to clear some things with you about the contract.
By that, I presume you mean the terms. Okay, this is it. You and I will be married only on papers. There will be no sex, no fondness of any kind, no emotions, except in public. My father and the public must believe this is real. You're free to do with your life whatever you please. Your social life is yours for the taking, but do not do anything negative. I hate scandals. You owe me no domestic responsibilities or chores. Have I cleared your confusion?
No.
What else?
Why me? You could get as many girls as you want for free. Why me?
Your mother is a very wise woman. Your father owes me, and you're in love with another man, so she knows there wouldn't be any emotional toss-up. Are you in or not?
I may be losing the woman I love over this.
Who cares what you lose over what? Don't care. Don't give a hoot. I don't give a flying fuck about whatever you lose. If you have accepted to do this, then whatever comes out of it, do not blame anybody because I'm not forcing you. Yes or no?
It could begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly, in this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life.
Good afternoon, Mr. and Mrs. Kofi.
Good afternoon, Mr. Ezra.
Dad. Mom. I've made up my mind to marry Baron.
Come. Come, my daughter. Come. Thank you so much. I know you will never let us down. Thank you. Mr. Eze, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
My daughter, I'm sorry for putting you into this. I know it's not easy for you to give up on Jerry. Thank you, Mr. Ezra.
You're welcome, Mr. Kofi.
One more thing. This arrangement has to be a top secret amongst us. My father must be convinced that this is real because he hinged my inheritance on this. So, the whole idea is to make it look as real as possible. Am I clear?
You can count on us. My daughter is a very private person.
Thank you.
Your secret is safe with us.
Very good. All right, Bianca, see you around.
All right, thank you.
Sorry, one more thing. Mr. Kofi, you might have to sign some documents for me.
What documents?
Actually, just a little insurance to cover this whole arrangement and to let you know that I'll take back this house if your daughter breaches her contract.
Not on her life. Trust us. Please.
I will.
Very good.
My lawyer will bring the parcel at any time.
No, what other plan B could she have? After all, the house is theirs.
And what if she's just trying to punish you for taking the house in the first place? Or maybe she will try to get that to know that this has all been an arranged marriage.
Sis, she wouldn't dare. You know why?
Why?
Because the contract states that for settling her father's debt, I get to run that house for the next 5 years, so it's not theirs yet.
Bro, you're just a shrewd businessman.
I know, I know. Just business security.
Oh my God. Brother. So when do I get to meet her?
By weekend. We'll see her.
My brother, businessman.
I have to.
Alright. Let me take you to where we're going to get our beautiful ring.
Okay, good. You say you know exactly where they say diamonds.
Don't you trust your sister?
I trust you.
We're going to get a very beautiful
ring. I trust you.
It could begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly, in this journey of life.
Okay, have this envelope. In it contains our daily itinerary from now till the next 1 month when we're getting married.
So soon?
Yeah, my father wants to see us get married before he passes on.
Sorry about your father's ill health. What's wrong with him?
Don't bother about that. Don't worry. Anyways, I'm used to getting reminded of what I need to do every day all my life. And I hope that you'll keep up with this and remind me of everything we need to do every day as regards this. The whole idea is to convince my father what we're doing is real.
There's a check in here.
Yeah, that's true. That's for your dentist appointment and any other thing you might need to put in place.
Dentist?
Mm-hmm.
I have a tooth problem.
I'll be kissing you in public. And I need to know the state of your oral health.
And what makes you think I have a poor oral hygiene?
If you didn't, you wouldn't be getting all worked up. We'll also be having a HIV screening.
What for? You and I won't be sleeping together anyway.
If you're positive, I won't be kissing you deeply.
Why all this after signing the contract?
The contract says that if either of us at any point realizes the other person has a viral deadly disease, the person is free to back off. You're still a virgin, so I'm not scared of any sexually transmitted disease.
Sorry? Who told you about that?
Well, that was meant to be a joke, but you just confirmed it. I'll be waiting for you. You can fight it all you want. You can resist it all you want. At the end of the day, time always stands. Oh, but what you have at the end of the day may be to your advantage. You can fight it all.
love could find you. Oh, that is life, the journey of
life. I love that young man.
Mom, you scared me.
Have you been listening?
Of course. I have a very good feeling about all this.
So, tell me, how much did he sign for you in that check?
200,000 naira.
Just for today?
No. I think it's for me to use and get some stuff before the wedding.
Bianca, that's not how I understood his statement.
He wants me to go see a dentist to ascertain the state of my hygiene. Mom, can you imagine? Because he simply wants to be kissing me in public.
So? What's wrong with that? At least that shows that he already has a good oral hygiene.
Mom, it's pointless arguing with you. I need to get going.
Have fun and try to relax me with him.
No one can be relaxed with the dynamite.
This journey could change your story. It could be good or it could be bad.
She has an excellent oral hygiene, Mr. Eze. And we still did the normal washing and polishing. So she's good to go.
You sure?
Yeah, very sure, I'm very sure.
All right, thank you, Doctor.
Yeah, you're welcome, Mr. Eze.
We have to take our leave now.
Wow, no problem. Goodbye, Miss Kofi.
Thank you.
See you soon.
Miss Kofi?
What's your problem?
You are my problem. How dare you humiliate me like that? Disgusting me as if I was not there. Like I'm some laboratory animal for experiment or what? We can pull this stupid stunt without a kiss or whatever.
No. We cannot pull this stunt without a kiss. We have to make... As a matter of fact, we have to start now.
Whoa. Who do we have here?
DJ!
Strongest baron in town.
What's up, bro?
I'm good.
Sorry. TJ, meet my girlfriend, Bianca. Bianca TJ, my friend.
Bianca, you are very beautiful.
Thank you.
I hope you'll be inviting us soon enough.
Yes, in the nearest future.
Whoa.
So what brings you here?
I came to see my doctor friend.
Okay, you two have issues with you.
Nah. A friend.
Okay. Alright, bro. We'll see you some other time.
Baron, the baron. Maxwell would definitely be your
DJ. Easy, man.
Hey, Jack.
What's that for? You almost blew things up back there. Don't you know TJ is Maxwell's friend? What if he had observed what we were doing?
I just don't like you kissing me like that. As if you want to squash me.
The least you could do is kiss me back. It wouldn't hurt. Move this car.
It could begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly, in this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life.
Hey, come. Why are you in a haste?
Why are you in a hurry to go in?
I have a headache.
My kiss gave you a headache.
Not just your kiss. Everything about you gives me a headache.
Anyways, you should develop immunity against me. Because you'll need it. Very, very much. Alright, I'll see you at 7 p.m.
For what?
Like you've not gone through the envelope I gave you yesterday. You were busy whining about you visiting the dentist and all of that. Well, we're having dinner at Eco Hotels tonight, and I am proposing to you there in full glare of everyone.
Is all this necessary?
Very necessary. And you better act all emotional because the press will be there as well.
What?
I'm not good at repeating myself, Bianca. Use the money I gave you to buy yourself some good clothes, make your hair look presentable, and look like a woman I could go for.
Really? And what kind of woman do you go for?
A woman with class, poise, intelligence, and beauty. Catch ya.
Sometimes life takes you on a journey where it's taking you, you don't know. When you get there, what you find.
Hello, TJ. Boy, I do. You can't believe what my old man just told me right now. Baron just informed him that he has found a wife. I know what that means. TJ, I am finished. Finished!
You know what? Let's meet at the bar tonight.
By 9 is okay. Okay, talk to you then.
Are you okay?
And what difference does it make if I'm not?
Should I get your food?
My friend, get out. I'm not hungry.
You could find a love, love could find you. Oh, that is life, the journey of life. Sometimes life takes you on a journey,
on a journey
where it's taking you, you don't know. When you get there,
what you find
could be a surprise,
a big surprise.
This journey could change your story.
Hi Jay, he's here. Mom, are you sure about this? My dear, we all need already. Just trust me on this. Please. Mom, you know I'm doing this for you and Dad. Thank you. Give me a hug. Please. Come on. You'll be fine.
Begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly, in this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life, yeah. And you have no idea where it's gonna take.
you this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life. Oh, you can fight it and resist it, but all to no avail.
Wow.
Even though it's costing you.
I must say, you look good tonight. You gotta go along with the ride. You don't wear a long face when you're going for your engagement. You should know that. Put a smile on that face because the press is already seated there. Open the car for her. Get into the car and let's go.
You don't know when you get there. What you find could be a surprise. A surprise. This journey could change your story.
Hello, Biron. Yes. What game do you think you're playing this time around?
I don't understand that.
Of course you do. What is this I'm reading in the papers? You and some lady. What's going on?
Dad, you know the press will always link me with one lady or the other just to sell the papers. You know that already.
Oh, don't give me that. You definitely know. If not, you're not going to be kissing her and caressing her in public. And then proposing to her. I thought you would take your time to at least study her, not this.
Well, they got that too.
Oh, now, just pretend to me that you don't know anything about this publicity spot.
I don't. It's just a private dinner.
That's why we went to that restaurant, Dad.
Those press guys are something else.
Really? Try and convince me. I don't even believe that any Nigerian journalist will take his camera at that time of the night. Smart enough to capture this kind of moment. Oh, come on, bro.
You're not half as shocked as I am, Dad.
Well, just bring her to me this weekend, or even earlier.
Okay, I will. Have a nice day, Dad.
Hello, son?
Dad?
Oh, come on, bro. This time around, let it just be real. Don't even try to fool me because you can't.
It's real.
Waiting to go. Bye.
Goodbye, Dad.
When you get there, what you find could be a surprise. A surprise.
This dream of surprises
could change your story. It could be good or it could be bad. And you could be caught up in it.
Are you okay? Jimmy broke up with me. He saw the paper.
Yes, he did. Half the whole world have seen the papers and been blasted on them.
Did you explain to him?
He wouldn't listen.
That's selfish and childish of him. He would do exactly the same, even worse, if he were in your shoes.
But Mom, I still love him.
Come on. You'll get over him. Hmm? Don't have to worry. See, I have the meaning to tell you. Why don't you use this opportunity, this situation to... You know what I mean?
How, Mom?
Turn the contract into real marriage.
Mom? How can you say such a thing?
Is it not the wisest thing to do now that you've parted ways with Jerry?
Sounds like you've been praying for this, Mom. I love him.
All I'm thinking of right now is how to make him understand and see reasons with me so he can wait for me.
You will do no such thing. You are Baron's fiancé.
Mom, this is all a facade.
And your Jerry can blow it, my dear. Think. Bianca! You don't walk out on me.
Mom, please, I have a headache. I need to think on how to make my relationship with Jerry come back, please.
Full begin, so unexpectedly. Sometimes, unpleasantly. In this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life. Yeah. And you have no idea where it's gonna, where it's gonna take you. This journey of life. Oh, this journey of life. Oh, you could fight it and resist it, but all to no avail.
Franca. Franca. The gardener didn't come to work?
No, sir. I've not seen him today.
All right. Get me one of the dailies.
Okay, sir.
You don't know when you get there, what you find could be a surprise. A surprise. This journey will change your story.
Any other things?
No. Go do what you're doing.
Even when you think you've got it all figured out, when you think you know the outcome by the end of the day, you could be shocked when you
Hey, Dad.
Baron.
Good afternoon, Dad.
Good afternoon, Baron. How are you?
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Dad, meet Bianca. Bianca, my dad.
Ah, it's my pleasure. Well, get yourself some seats.
Okay, let me get you a seat. I'm coming.
So, Bianca, where did you meet my son? You haven't forgotten, have you?
No, sir. I met him when I went for an interview at the company.
So he offered you marriage instead of a job?
Dad, I simply discovered she has a great personality.
That must have been quite an interview.
It was, Dad, indeed. I was stunned. In fact, I was captured by her heart that very moment.
And you, Bianca? Were you also stunned by my son's heart?
No, yes, sir. But not his heart.
Tell me more.
It was his determination for excellence, his strength and aura pulled me to him. His heart I'll get to know over time.
I see. Okay. Once again, you're welcome to my home.
Thank you, sir.
We should have lunch.
Yes, Dad, we should.
Franca would have made something.
Okay, then, let's go inside.
It could begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly, in this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life. Yeah. And you have no idea where it's gonna take you. This journey of life. Oh,
journey of life. Welcome, madam.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is Mamojo, my housekeeper. Mamojo, Bianca, my new wife.
Welcome, ma. I'm at your service anytime, ma.
Thank you. I have some luggage in the boat.
I will get it, madam. Don't worry.
Okay then, Mamojo will help you settle in. I have to rush back to work now.
I'm sorry. Where will I be sleeping?
Well, in one of the visitors' rooms, obviously. Probably the one opposite mine. I do not have space for two in mine.
Sir, can I have the key to your room?
What for?
So that I take Madame things inside.
Were you deaf when I said a while ago that she was going to stay in the visitors' room opposite mine? That my room didn't have space for two?
Sorry, sir.
All right, I'm off to work. See you later.
Okay, sir.
Figured out. Yes. I really feel something wrong like that. Love goes soft. I swear. You should know that love is soft. It can eat you anywhere at any time.
That one is something wrong. That one needs to be disputed. I think she's wrong.
Funny enough, I already knew that.
Come on, Dad. You're going to allow me to marry you. It's a good thing.
I have a chance. Because you do. Which is.
Reject now. Insist that Baron marries someone that we know, someone that we trust.
Listen, that is not necessary. Baron that I know will never get into an entire world.
You are still awake?
Yes, I am. Please stay up so late. His phone is switched off.
He does come back late sometimes. But I'm a bit worried. Because this is wedding night. Sorry to say that, madam. I shouldn't have.
Madam, I think you should go to bed.
You're back.
Welcome, sir.
What's going on here? Why are you both still up at this time?
I was worried about you. You stayed out so late.
Are you not my watchdog?
Good night, sir. Good night, madam. Excuse me.
You see what you almost cost? Now, don't you ever do this.
What have I done wrong?
Staying up late to wait for me when you know you're not my real wife.
Sorry about that. You didn't tell me we stayed out so late.
I owe you no explanation! I could stay out for eternity for all I care. Now you listen to me. This is business. Strictly business.
Fine, I know it's business. And I'm not trying to turn it to anything else. I was just being worried about
you. You have no reason to get that into your thick skull.
Yeah.
do. This thing that I feel is so strong. This feeling can't be wrong. Oh, oh. Should I give in? Should I get out? I don't know what to do.
Good morning, madam. I hope you slept well on your first night in your home.
I slept as for well. I don't know. I couldn't sleep till 4 a.m. Is it gone?
Yes, madam. Your breakfast will soon be ready.
Okay. And as for this whole madam title, please, can you drop it? Call me Bianca. You're old enough to be my other sister, you know.
I don't think Oga will like that.
Trust me, that is the least of the things Oga will bother about.
If you insist.
Yes, I insist. Mm-hmm. So back to breakfast. What do we have?
I will get omelette for you. Hope you like that.
Okay.
So, excuse me.
Hello.
Oh. Oga gave me this.
Good morning, Bianca. This is a list of your itinerary for the day. By 1:15 p.m., you are to bring me lunch in the office, not a minute early or late. And be reminded, you should act like a new bride. Then at night by 8 p.m., we'll be at a friend's engagement party. Wear something sexy, but decent and not suggestive. Call me if you're confused. Baron.
What does he like for lunch?
He never does lunch. Just coffee in the morning and the dinner. Did he ask for lunch? In that case, we get him a good food.
Babe, take him easy now. Eh? Easy now.
Baron is a mean son of a bitch. I've been on his beck and call for 2 years. I traveled for just 2 months. 2 months! He rushes off to marry a strange girl.
Waiting they pin me pass, we say. That girl no even follow for A-list babes for this town. She no follow now. You see what they tell you since? Make you get belay for this guy. But you no listen. You didn't listen.
How am I supposed to get pregnant when he insists on using condoms?
You should have pierced it now. Ah.
When he buys them himself and wears them himself.
Men are beasts.
I'm doomed. Babe, I'm doomed. How am I supposed to pay my rent? My rent will be due in 2 months.
But you still have other men that do take care of you.
Other men? I don't want other men. I want Baron. Babe, see, you won't understand. Baron is not only good in bed, Baron is kind, Baron is caring, Baron is generous to a fault. Babes, you understand.
Married men are more generous, especially our senators, our chairman, name them. You know, they give without looking back. You see, now is your opportunity to milk him.
I don't want to milk him. I don't want to milk Baron. I want him back. I don't want those men. I want Baron.
You want Baron, fine. Now that he has not been picking your calls, and he has never returned your calls,
What are you going to do? If Baron fails to call me this week, I will go and see him myself.
Good and fine. Wait till Kari come back for me.
Oh my God. I told you that I am worried on how to get money to pay my rent. And all you ask is what I got for you from Dubai, right?
See me see local wahala. Nobody go choose Leki. Leave Yenekbaja.
Oh my God. But you know I can't stay in a place like this. I can't stay in Yenekbaja.
You cannot stay in a place like this. So we don't stay where they stay for here. We don't die finish. Eh? You go choose Leki. You no get work. Oh. Very soon, breeze go blow. Go see far on yash. See babes. Now I tell you. If I dress up like this, package myself, come outside, I go change my Instagram location. Nobody go know where they stay now.
Oh my God! You know, I'm not cut out for all these fake lives. Yeah, they're fake.
See who they talk. See who they talk fake life. Nobody they live fake life. You where they stay for Leki, you no get job. Now they call me fake life, Abby. Very soon now, your rent will expire now.
It's okay. He don't do.
He never
do. He don't do. I beg. I'm very hungry. I'm going to cook.
See, like you may be hungry. No worry. I get Gary. Ma go bring her out. Me will soak.
Wait. Me? Take Gary.
Waka.
No. Me? Take Gary.
Shege.
You're my friend now.
My friend.
Considering the fact your dad had this transaction 30 years ago, when some laws on properties were different from what we have today, simply means some terms don't apply.
Son, any problem?
No, Dad. Why do you ask?
You keep glancing at your wristwatch as if you have another appointment somewhere. If you don't mind, the barrister and I can reschedule.
No, I'm fine. Let's continue. Barrister, please.
So, I will advise your dad sells off and let the buyer face the stress that will come in the nearest future.
So, what do you think, son?
Well, the barrister knows best. Let's just go with his flow.
In that case, go on and sell. You bring the papers to me over the weekend, okay, so I can sign it and return.
Okay, sir.
Okay?
You're leaving already?
Haven't we concluded? We have. So that you can have enough time to attend to that thing that made your eyes glue to the wristwatch.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
Madam just arrived. She said it's urgent.
Oh, my wife. Yes. Let her in.
Okay, sir.
Hey, on the pie. You look worried, darling. Is everything okay? Anyway, barrister, meet my lovely wife, Bianca. Barrister Solomon.
Good day, sir.
Wow. It's wonderful meeting the girl that has finally captured the heart of Nigeria's once recalcitrant bachelor.
You know, I feel like an achiever with that title.
I think we'll have to take our leave now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Let me give you a hand.
Okay.
Bianca, you really look harassed. One advice for you. Next time, don't put yourself under the pressure to meet Biron's demands. Son.
Dad.
See you over the weekend.
I'll see you too, Dad.
Let's go.
Be fine and be strong.
Oh, yes.
A simple assignment. And you blew it away.
I would have been here on time, but...
Save me your lousy explanations! If you had done things right, something you could have simply executed and would make my father believe we were real. No, you messed it up. A simple task of bringing food for your husband and pretending to show a little affection. You couldn't do it.
I'm sorry, the traffic was too much.
Now get out of my office and go with your food.
Begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly, in this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life, yeah. And you have no idea where it's gonna take you. This journey of life, oh, this journey of life, oh.
Well, barrister, so what do you think about my son and his new wife?
Oh, those two are very much in love with each other. Yeah, from my own observations, especially the girl, can't you see? She's trying not to offend him. My wife was once like that, you know.
And my son?
Your son. I think he loves her more. Yeah, he loves her more. He's only trying not to show it too much. Perhaps the girl might take him for granted. You know, men. Or do you have any doubt about the girl?
Not her, but my son.
It could begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly in this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life, yeah. And you have no idea where it's going.
Hi, Janice.
I thought the tabloids.
Janitor. Wow. Dinner tonight. Woo! Ben!
What are you saying? I mean, you had to make your choice and you chose him.
How many times do you want me to explain to you that this thing is not real?
So that is the reason why you made mockery of our love? Then secondly, you made our love so cheap! If you don't mind, I need to get back to the office, please.
Jerry, please don't do this. I had no choice. My parents would have been homeless by now.
Oh, that's a lie. Bianca, I said that's a lie. Your parents had too many folks out there that they would have been able to put up with till we're able to sort out the accommodation. But what did I get in return? You wanted to remain in the big mansion.
Jerry, we can still work something out now.
How do you mean? After he has had you?
There won't be any sex. There won't be.
Listen to me, Mrs. Eze. You can't eat your cake and have it. I have to get back to work. Excuse me.
How are you?
I'm fine, Adam.
Where is everybody?
Oh, they should be somewhere all around the house. So what brings you?
Dad, I'd like to see you, but in private.
Really? Well, but we're alone here.
And I prefer us to be in your room, sir.
All right, let's go to the carport. It's where. Come on.
So what is it, Maxwell? It's about Baron's father-in-law.
What about him?
The man is owing the company 15 million naira. And he's a chronic gambler. But when the time came for him to pay back, he couldn't pay back. So the company took over his property.
Naturally. Where you owe and you have a collateral, we take over.
But do you know what happened eventually? Baron paid off the debt.
Well, the man is his father-in-law, so there's nothing bad in him doing that.
He paid off before marrying her.
Come on, Dad. You don't get it. This is so clear. He pays off the debt, and in exchange, she marries Baron. Just to fool you. It's hard to believe, but it is true. Why would Baron pay off so much debt if he's not getting something in return?
Let me ask you this. What if he did it because of the love he has for his wife?
Okay. Okay. Yeah. This phone has a recording application. It can record for several hours. Just place it in their room and you will confirm what I have just told you.
You have to. You need to do it. And you will. That's why I came.
Turn this contract marriage into real.
Mom, you know that's not possible.
Your Jerry got married last week.
It's a lie.
See? I have the picture because my friend attended. The girl in question is her niece. So, you need to crack him.
Get pregnant. How? How? You know, Baron does not love me.
Say school.
Tell me, who would pay dearly for a contract marriage? Are you the only girl around? I'm a woman and I know things. When I see them, I can tell some things. Bianca, it will be foolish of you to leave Baron's house after this contract.
Because no man would want you.
He is too popular. So men will be scared to go for his ex-wife. You have money, yes. But hard market.
Mom, I don't know what to do.
Give him an heir.
Yes.
No man would like to divorce you with that.
Believe me.
What do I do? Please tell me what to do.
Come.
This time.
What do you mean?
What do I mean? What's that show of love for?
I'm just doing what you asked me to do. Convince you that this is real.
Is that why you have to kiss me in that manner?
Like how?
Listen, I don't have any time for any dumb argument with you. Leave my room, I want to take my shower.
Okay, but be fast.
The
real is real, otherwise
you get cold. Hey! What's this new madness of making with you?
Don't you think you don't make your way? That's suspicious.
You don't have to make it. Just be in the kitchen with Mamoju and have her do the meal.
But he frequents the kitchen!
You do not have to go all the way to prove anything to him! Now get out! I need to take my shower.
Could begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly, in this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life, yeah. And you have no idea where it's gonna, take you. This journey of life, oh, this journey of life, oh, you could fight it and resist it, but all to no avail. Even though it's causing you pain, you gotta go along with the ride, gotta flow with the tide.
Sometimes life takes you on a journey.
Oh my God, you scared me. I didn't hear you driving. How was your day?
Ain't you supposed to have had a bath before I come back, so we don't have to struggle for space?
I slept and woke up late.
You always have an excuse. Call me when you're done.
Baron!
Mm-hmm.
Got it all figured out. When you think you know the outcome at the end of the day, you could be shocked when you realize you were wrong all along. You can fight it all you want.
Bianca! Bianca!
Yeah?
What's the meaning of this?
It's not what you think. You know, this whole marriage thing happened so soon. I had to explain things to him.
And you had to do that by going to his house and the hospital?
He wouldn't give me audios at work, so I had to go to his house.
Can imagine what that led to.
Baron, what do you care?
Maxwell sent me this picture now. And if this gets out, you know what it's going to do to our plans.
Sorry.
Sorry for yourself. Just clean this mess and make sure this doesn't happen again. That's all.
Madam, I said, lunch is served.
Should I give in? Should I get out? Don't know what to do. This thing that I feel is so strong. This feeling can't be wrong.
Oh, oh. Baron! Maxwell! Baron, what am I doing, sir? What was that show you pulled in the office? Why did you have my wife? Why have you been looking for me all this while? Get out! Why did you have my wife followed? Your fake wife, you mean? Baron, you cannot fool everybody. Not even me, okay? Not even Dad! Whatever you're planning with that girl of yours, I'll make sure it doesn't work out. You're the one who is fooling yourself. Trying to steal an inheritance that is not yours. Still mine. You are an illegitimate son. Oh, really? But that still doesn't change the fact that Harold's blood flows in my veins. Now listen, let me tell you, Maxwell. Stay away from my wife and anything that concerns me. Stay away. I know about all your fraudulent transactions. If you think I do not know, I have the tabs on you. And I know about all the women you keep outside, claiming to love your wife. One more blackmail from you, and you're done for. Come back here, come! I'm not going to take this shit from you again. Baron, whatever you call yourself. Just... Okay. I know what to do.
Dad, you see what I've been telling you? She's already having an affair.
But Maxwell, if you ask me, these two seem to be quarreling in all the pictures I have seen.
That's possible.
How do you mean?
Well, the young guy is your daughter-in-law's ex-boyfriend. Or perhaps, secret lover. She has visited him in his house and in the hospital, as you can see. Well, the private detective I employ has been following her around ever since she said they got married.
For that long? Oh, Maxwell, these pictures I'm seeing seem to have been taken in one day.
What does it change? It doesn't change anything.
Well, this is strange. Very strange. New wife? Still in contact with her ex-lover?
Current lover, you mean?
This journey of life, yeah, and you have...
So sorry I kept you waiting. I was doing something. You sounded very urgent on the phone. Is everything alright?
Everything is fine.
Okay.
Baron called me.
Okay.
And he said I should inform you that Dad will be coming to your house to spend some time with you people. And what that means is that Dad wants to come and monitor you people, both of you, to know if all this is true.
So
please, just cooperate and then make sure that Dad doesn't find out anything as long as he stays there.
So, why did Baron ask you to tell me? Why didn't he talk to me directly?
You know, my brother can be weird at times. Well, he thinks I can communicate with you better. And that's all. There's nothing behind it. Just stay cool and communicate and cooperate so that Dad won't find out anything. You know my dad, he can be inquisitive.
No problem, I've heard you. I will try my best.
I know you will. Thank you very much for your understanding. I really appreciate everything.
It's okay. So, let me get back to what I was doing.
Okay, darling.
Okay, thank you.
Alright, do take care of yourself, okay?
You too.
Alright. Bye.
Bye.
Bianca, what in God's name are you still doing here? Time to go to bed. What's happening to me? I don't understand. I don't understand. This isn't how it's supposed to be. What's happening to me? I don't understand. Oh, should I?
give in? Oh, should I get out? I don't know what to do. Oh, should I give in? Should I get out? I don't know what to do. I can't fight it anymore. No, no, I can't fight it anymore. I can't fight it anymore. Fight it anymore. I can't fight it anymore. Oh. Should I give in? Should I get out? I don't know what to do. This feeling I feel is so strong. This feeling can't be wrong. No, can't fight it anymore. I can't fight it anymore.
What's the meaning of this? Can't you stay on your
own? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah. Should I give in? Should I get out? Don't know what to do. This thing that I feel is so strong. This feeling can't be wrong. Oh, oh. Should I give in? Should I get out? Don't know what to do. This thing that I feel.
Bianca, how are you?
Okay. Please, where is mommy?
Is everything okay? You don't look happy.
Please, where is mommy?
Well, she's inside.
I can't find it anymore. Can't find it anymore. Oh no. This wasn't the plan. What's happening to me? I don't understand. I don't
Mom, understand. Those pictures have really spoiled my chances of winning you. That was silly of you going to see Jerry. Why would you do that? Mom, I hurt him. I owe him an explanation. Sweetheart, you don't owe him a thing. If he had loved you, he would have waited for you. Or don't you think so? You know, Mom, I keep wondering why he rushed into marriage so soon. Now you've started thinking smartly. Now let me lecture you. Men always have plan B at the back of their heart. Better know that. My dear, you need to go back there. Continue from where you stopped. You must get pregnant at all costs. You see, Baron? He will crack. Believe me. You don't have to think about it much. Believe me.
This thing that I feel is so strong.
Who do we have here? Can't you greet your supposed
brother-in-law.
I don't owe you any greeting. Maxwell, I believe Baron has warned you to stay away from me.
Baron, your supposed husband. I believe you're so good in bed. That's why Baron picked you from the slum. Hey! Come on, don't you dare.
Let go of me.
Don't you ever try that again. You better watch your back. Because I'm watching you.
No, not now.
What is the problem?
Nothing, I just had a stressful day at work today.
Oh, is it at home? So I'm right.
No, you are wrong.
You know I'm actually being nice here.
Excuse me?
Yes. So how many girls could have taken you back after what you did?
If I remember vividly, I never made any commitment to you.
God. So it was just sex for you?
And it was just the checks for you.
Oh God, you are so despicable.
I agree. Suit yourself. Please let me go drop you off. I'm not in the mood to argue.
If you leave this place, I will never take you back.
That's fine.
You're leaving.
Why didn't you call me the minute it happened?
I didn't think it was necessary. Kenneth intervened on time.
But you asked him not to tell me, right?
Both of you have enough heat already. I don't want to add more to it.
Now you listen. Henceforth, you're going to move around with bodyguards. I don't trust Maxwell. He's savage. He's ruthless. Okay? You are my ticket to my inheritance. And getting rid of you will give him great joy. Did he hurt you?
Just a little pain.
You sure? Oh, I'm sorry.
I thought Bianca was downstairs in the kitchen, so I assumed you'd be here as well. Well, your husband and wife are teenagers, so you can continue with what you're doing. Don't make it look like I got you one simple act. Come on. I'll see you downstairs.
Thank you.
is what? Gosh. Mrs. Eze.
Yes? I'm sorry. I can't remember you. Have we met?
No, we haven't. I traveled outside the country when you married my boyfriend.
I beg your pardon?
You heard me right, gold digger.
Hey, look here, young lady. It's like you're high on drugs or something. You better leave here before I beat you up. The fact that he left you and married my daughter, it shows that you're a slut.
Oh, I see. It's out of a murder.
You
slapped me?
Oh, something your lousy mother refused to teach you a long time ago. And if you don't take time, I will do it again and again.
You will pay for this.
Excuse me?
You will pay for this! I've been kind all this while to let Baron, your so-called husband, come back to you every night. From now on, he will never come back to you again.
Look at this bamboo clap. It's not a threat.
Hey, you!
You don't do that to my
mom, please, mom, please!
Why did your mom assault James?
Oh, so you heard?
Answer my question.
She insulted my mother. Don't I expect you to care?
Let this be the first and the last time you face your first happy.
And let it be the last time your girlfriend insults me, my mother will be with my family. I don't care what you say in my house. Go ahead and please. Stay with me!
Why does it bother you who I have sex with? Say.
This thing that I feel is so strong. This feeling can't be wrong. I can't fight it anymore. I can't fight it anymore.
The reason I didn't use Janice or any of my close friends is because I do not want any emotional hassle.
And who is experiencing it amongst the both of you?
From what I told you, who does it look like?
You, of course.
Me? Mm-hmm. You must be joking. We fall for that girl.
She's beautiful.
I have been with so many beautiful women in my time.
But none loves you like she does.
Indeed that.
Baron, why don't you give this a chance and see if it will work? What do you have to lose?
She's just not my type.
Who is your type? All those ones that sees you as a dollar sign?
They are safer. They don't get too close and they give me what I want.
Oh, I see. So, Bianca has gotten so close. What about what you need?
I have everything I need.
This is what I've been trying to tell you. You need Bianca. Don't let her go. She's all you need.
You see what I don't like about this whole scenario? I don't know why I brought you into this in the first place. Why I even invited you to come talk about it. Why I even let you into the secret? If you don't mind, I have somewhere to go, please.
Hello? Where are you? Are you living without me? I thought you were going together for lunch.
We're not going anymore. I have an appointment to keep up with. What's funny?
You're always like this whenever you're being confronted with the truth.
And what's the truth in this?
You are falling.
Me?
Yes, you.
Falling. You're not serious.
Bros, you're falling.
Get your ass off that seat. Let's go eat new soup.
You can never change.
So, how has married life been with my brother?
Well, not bad.
I know my invitation came to you as a surprise. Well, I was with my brother the other day, and he complained about you.
Me?
My brother thinks that you are trying to seduce him, which is contrary to the contract. Is that true?
I'm just trying to be nice.
She's nice. You love him, don't you? Well, I called you here to give you a sound advice. That is, if you take it.
You mean?
Exactly what you think I mean.
I mean trying. I doubt if he will give in.
He will. Trust me. You know you are a very hot number, my dear.
Baron is not moved by looks. I'm very sure he has seen so many beautiful women in his life.
Yeah, that's for sure. But a man knows when a woman loves him genuinely. And that is powerful, my dear.
Is it that obvious that I love him?
Yes, madam. It's very obvious. I can't see any ring on that finger.
Well, you and I know that I'm not married.
Bianca, of course you are married to my brother.
Cool begin, so unexpectedly. Sometimes, unpleasantly, in this journey of life. Oh, this journey of life.
Well, it was wonderful spending time with you, Bianca.
Thank you, sir. The pleasure is all mine.
Well, I'm happy that what started as a deceit on my son's part finally became a conquest of his heart by you. Oh, come on. I know all that has been happening. Yes. My son accepted destiny in you without knowing it. I'm glad. Come on. Wake up. This is a private conversation between us. Baron must never hear anything about it. Okay?
So, will you deny him his inheritance?
Oh, that? It's up to him. My dear, Just hang in there. Don't ever give up. He runs away whenever you break him. Don't worry. Well, I would want you to visit me sometime. As soon as Dr. Mary settles in, I invite both of you for lunch or dinner. Okay? All right, so just snap out of it. It's still a private conversation.
Thank you.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Happy birthday,
sir. Thank you. Happy birthday. Three hearty cheers for Daddy. Hip, hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip, hip. Let's have a toast on Daddy's
behalf. All right, let's go.
I can't wait. Yeah. It's a very happy day.
Well, my wish is that I will see my children's children.
And children's children's children.
Especially from... Oh!
There we go. Come on.
Let's go.
I don't understand this young man. Just the time we think that the whole thing has clicked, he ran off. Not to think that he left such a terrible letter for you after the whole thing. And you say he's been gone for 2 weeks.
Away from house, yes. But has been going to the office for the past 1 week.
Are you sure you didn't offend him?
The only thing I did was let him make love to me that night.
So, did he?
Did he what?
Come on, Bianca, you know what I mean.
Mom, I think you should stop talking about that night. I should have allowed things to be the way they were before.
My dear, you don't say such a thing. Your prayer should be that you end up being pregnant for him.
Never! Never, Mom!
Have you tried to go to the office and talk it over with him?
I would do no such thing. I've had it with him. I would not allow him to humiliate me again. Never.
You know what I think? I think this man has started loving you and it scares him because that wasn't part of the plan.
Couldn't care less. All I want now is just to be left alone. I'm tired. I am tired of this whole thing.
The letter. Well, do I keep it? You need to take it easy then.
It could begin so unexpectedly. Sometimes unpleasantly. In this journey of life, oh, this journey of life, yeah. And you
have... Oh, Bianca, you are here. What's the problem? You look worried.
Has he returned home yet? Boy must be very stubborn.
My dear, take it easy. Mr. Eze here has told me a lot that has been happening. You must be a brave woman to win the heart of a man like Baron.
Sir, please.
Young woman, if it's about the inheritance, no. Only a deserving son will get it.
Take it easy, okay? Just calm down. Everything will be okay. Okay? Just calm down. Please.
It could be good, or it could be bad. You could be caught up in it before you realize it. Oh, even when you think you've got it all figured out. When you think you know the outcome by the end of the day.
Where are you coming from?
I want to see my mom, then had dinner with your dad and Dr. Mary. So I slept over.
So why did you sleep over?
I didn't want to come back home to an empty house.
My mojo is in this house.
She's not my husband.
Neither am I. Why are you complicating things? The terms of the contract are clear.
Things seemed so to me the night you made love to me.
I knew you were going to hold on to that. Now you listen to me, you and I know that was a mistake. The earlier we put that behind us, the better for both of us. I've done that already. So you have to.
Lucky you. Some of us, it's not easy for the first man who made love to us, especially when he tells us he loves us while doing it. So, it's not easy.
Better get over that.
No! Do you want to kill my father? This water is too cold. My father cannot take this. You want to kill him? Please, go and get him the water that is a bit warm.
Okay, please.
Why is it that you can't do it? Sit here, baby.
What are you planning to do after my
Algeria?
Are you going to marry her?
What do you think I should
do? Oh, come on, Dad.
Do you have to answer all my questions with question?
Well, I do so when I think you're not minding your own business. It's not a bad idea, though.
I like her, actually.
She's a nice person.
Well, so, what is happening between Baron and Bianca?
Sometimes you amaze me with your questions. Baron is your twin brother, so I should be asking you.
But Dad...
Anyway, I'm not even interested.
Baron is also your son.
I'm not interested, so let that discussion end. We've changed the topic. So how is your husband?
That you could never change. My husband is fine.
So how are things between you and Baron since they came back?
Different.
Different? Oh. Better, I guess.
Far from that. He blames me for our lovemaking. And the worst of it all is that I've lost all strength to make this whole thing work.
It's okay. Calm down. But that would be stupid of him. I saw the way he was looking at you that night. He wanted you with passion.
You guys cannot kill me. Welcome, bro.
What's going on here?
How?
You know how? The laughter before I came in and then the sudden change of mood when I walked in here. What's wrong?
Well, I think you should ask her. She's your wife.
Just on papers.
Come on, bro.
Come on, what?
Stop now.
Stop what? Is there food in the house, please?
Yes, of course. She'll get you food.
Did you cook?
Okay. Yes.
We'll get you something to eat.
Fast.
Oui.
Should I give in? Should I get out? Don't know what to do.
Bianca!
This thing that I feel is so strong. This feeling can't be wrong. Should I give in?
Oh, sweetie, don't.
Eddie,
I'm so sorry. I can't take this pain anymore. I just want to go. No. Don't. Don't say that, please. If you leave, he will lose everything.
I don't care. I don't care anymore.
Oh, yes, you do. Because you love him. Excuse me. Let me go set the table.
What's happening to me? I don't understand. I don't understand. This isn't how it's supposed to be. What's happening to me? I don't understand. Oh, should I give in? Oh, should I get out of it?
Are you all right?
My dad,
What about him?
He just went into coma.
Oh no!
Told me that, and I'm sorry I couldn't meet up with the invitation you sent over for dinner twice. I had a lot going on in my life at that time.
From the result of the test, it seems your dad has not been taking his drugs.
Why would he do like that?
Your father is a very stubborn man. He even fooled me too. Anyway, all hope is not lost, but let not expect hope to come.
Are you saying my father will hardly regain consciousness?
Never say never in medicine. I called his lawyer, which was his instruction. If this or death should occur.
Why would he ask you to call his lawyer?
He didn't explain. I'm very strange, I must say. A few days after I arrived, your dad told me that the lawyer knows what to do if I should make the call.
Why didn't you take him to a hospital?
He wouldn't want hospital if it could be avoided. And in that case, it is possible to do so.
I didn't expect this to happen now.
Just take it easy. Excuse me.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Without wasting much of your time, I want to go straight to read your father's will, Chief Eze. As I informed you all earlier on, your father left specific instructions that his will be read few days after his demise, or coma, whichever one that comes first. Becky, you are first. Your father left his shipping line to you. His Long Island home in the US, three of his houses in London, and his undeveloped 10 plots of land in Lekki Phase 2. Baron, your father specifically requested that I let you know he's aware of your arrangement with Bianca. He has, however, listed the following: his two estates in Port Harcourt, his oil palm plantation in the east, 50 million naira cash, half of his shares in the telecommunications sector, and his home on Osma Road, Ikoyi. You, Mr. Baron Eze, will see to that these listed properties are legally handed over to your half-brother, Mr. Maxwell Eze here.
What? What did you just say?
Barrister, please, can you put us through here? Because we're confused.
Yeah, I will. only if Maxwell will let me.
Maxwell.
What?
Please. You may continue.
And you, Mr. Baron, every other thing your father owns is under your control. Maxwell's shares still comes under you, but he expects you do honorable things as to give them to him. The list is endless, so no need to
deal it. I knew it. I smell foul play here. So, Baron, you connive with this lawyer to change Daddy's will.
Maxwell, watch your mouth. I'll do that for you.
Ah, you think Father didn't know? He knew about your plan with your wife. He couldn't have willed other things left. What do you mean?
What?
This won't work. I'm going to contest this will. It's not going to work.
You won't do anything about it. You don't tell Dad how to share his property.
Will you all calm down? Well, all you heard now is Mr. Ezek's will. And at this juncture, I beg to take my leave.
Baron, this will not work. This will not work.
You can't do anything about it. There is no point blabbing. Max, you know you can't do anything about it. You can't do anything about
it. It's okay, guys. It's okay. Please calm down.
First thing tomorrow morning, I have instructed Ben to transfer 15 million naira into your account.
What for?
For your troubles.
Thank you. Baron, is that all you feel for me?
Thank you.
I saw that.
You were actually meant to see that.
I'm happy for Mother.
Thank you. So how is Daddy doing?
You can go and see for yourself.
Let's go see Daddy.
Okay.
After you.
Alright.
Just wait. Just wait. Hi, Dad. Bianca and I have some good news. We have decided to make it real, just like you have always wanted. I love her.
Yes, Dad. We're expecting a baby.
Beautiful. Dad. Daddy. Dad! Dad! Daddy? Dad! Hey! Dad!
This is good!
Dad! So fun. Celebrating.
Wow!
Well, I'm sorry for doing what I did. Baron left me with no option. When I noticed his pride would not allow him to declare his love for Bianca, I had to let him have his inheritance and then make a final choice. But I'm glad that he did right.
So, Dad, you mean the will is still valid?
Oh, as real and as valid as your Nigerian citizenship.
So all this while I've been trying to
blackmail your brother? I allowed that happen to act as a distraction to prevent you from harming him.
So, Dad, you've been using me.
Well, let's just say that I have been toying with both of you. I'm sorry for that. Listen, Maxwell, stop feeling threatened. You're my son, and your father, I still love you. You will still have a part of the family inheritance. So, no need to worry yourself, okay? Now, I want you to make peace with your brother. Oh, yes. Come on, make peace with him. Go ahead. Baron, make peace with him. Go on, Baron. Make peace. To ask you this for the very last time and in the presence of my family. Dr. Mary, will you marry me?
Ah! Wow!
Yes, of course.
That?
Wow!
I didn't see this coming.
Yeah,
I didn't see this coming.
Thank you.
to begin so unexpectedly, sometimes unpleasantly. In this journey of life, oh, this journey of life, yeah. And you have no idea where it's gonna, where it's gonna take you. This journey of life, oh, this journey of life, oh, you will fight it and resist it, but all to no avail. Even though it's causing you pain, you gotta go along with the ride, gotta flow with the tide.